Hey everyone, this is Ferret, and welcome to my Let's Play of Sonic the Hedgehog, not the terrible one from 2006 everyone knows so well about, but the really, really good one from 1991 for the Sega Genesis. I'm playing a copy of the game via Steam, and it's only about 5 bucks, so if you haven't gotten it yet, I would recommend that you try it out. This game is considered to be one of the most defining and one of the best platforming games of all time. I would have to personally agree. Graphics are very nice, have multiple grounds, they're colorful, and they process really quickly, thanks to blast processing. Genesis does when Nintendo don't. The music's very cheerful, it has many instrumentals. It complements the level design pretty well. The levels have good design with multiple paths, which encourage exploration and experimentation, I would say. And it's combined with good amounts of speed control. And Sonic is really good at speed. It wasn't always about speed, it's mostly about the good level design, but the speed's a nice little bonus to have. The actual objective is pretty straightforward. You had to go from left to right usually, sometimes taking some obstacles and dealing with some of them. In order to get to a goal, you have to do it within 10 minutes. Rings count as your health. If you have at least one and you get hit, then you won't die, but you'll just drop them. If you do have no rings and you get hit, well, then you die. Now, one thing I did want to do to make this Let's Play stand out is that since I assume many of you guys have actually played this game before, I wanted to try and get some community involvement involved. So, if you leave in the comments below, you can either tell me level conditions, level challenges, or possible discussion topics for future episodes, and I might do them in the future. In fact, I already have two of them for this episode, thanks to some other G1s. So this first one comes from BlademAn916. And his request was to complete the stage in less than 2 minutes and 30 seconds without killing any enemies. So Sonic the Hedgehog has to become Sonic the Friendly Hedgehog for this particular level. We're gonna be a little bit more slow-paced, but not too slow because he did give me a time limit. We can get her ourselves, and we can get her with level design, but we can't do any damage to the robots, because apparently Sonic has become friendly and has started to get along with Robotnik. I guess he's just going for a nice little jog. There are innocent animals trapped in those robots, but hey, whatever. I like robots, don't you? You know, Furbies and all that stuff. No, I'm just kidding. So we're gonna take things pretty slowly, try and ninja dodge all the projectiles, and also try to avoid rolling if we can, because rolling builds up speed. And because there wasn't a spin dash in this game yet that didn't come out until later on, you would have to gain speed and then roll, you know, do it the old-fashioned way. So we're almost done, and we're doing pretty well so far. And challenge complete. Let's move on to the next one. Something you'll also notice is that this is the only Sonic Genesis game to actually give you points based on how you jump at the end. I thought that was a nice little touch. It's cool if you want to do a score challenge. This next challenge comes from Johnny Farrar, if I'm pronouncing his name correctly. And it was to get through a level without taking any damage from the robot enemies. I can take damage from the level design, but I can't get hurt by any of the enemies. Primarily the robots. So this isn't too bad, because we got an invincibility early on, which will, for I believe about 15 seconds, protect you from taking any enemy damage. That's certainly helpful. Sonic also has a spin attack, where you just jump into the air, and you can hit enemies, it won't work against the projectiles. I did just get hit there with the spikes, but technically that wasn't an enemy, so loopholes. So far we're doing pretty well. If we had 50 rings or more, we could jump into the big rings at the end and do a special stage, because there's 6 Chaos Emeralds, and if you get them all, you get a good ending. But on the third act, instead of having a big ring, we have boss enemies instead. So we'll see that coming up really shortly. And this is the first appearance of Robotnik. Yes, I am calling him Robotnik and not Eggman, because I don't think Eggman's very intimidating, because Robotnik implies a level of a threat. It's pretty simple, you gotta go back and forth and whoa, hello Ninja Sonic. Just avoid that ball right there. You gotta jump back and forth, avoid the wrecking ball. Physics, guys. This is pretty revolutionary when it first came out, all that physics stuff. And that was the first boss. Again though, this is the first video in a series of mine, and I do want to have community involvement. So again, in the comments, if you have any level challenges or discussion topics pertaining to Sonic the Hedgehog, feel free to leave those below and I might do them in the future. Thanks for watching.